Malcolm McLaren once said, the purpose of pop culture is to soften the blow of daily life. You know, get everybody so caught up in fun. There's a carrot on a stick that they buy and they buy and they buy. You can control it like rats in a maze, and they're more obedient shoppers, more easily used in the workforce. I mean, comic books. Who's your favorite cartoon character? Three Crows, Blue Penguin in Bloom County, you know, the Dewsbury people, Bullwinkle, Yogi Bear, Nancy Reagan, Muammar Gaddafi, George Duke Majin. What are they? They're cartoon characters. They don't have any real power. Somebody pays to put them there and tells them what to do and hands them the right cue cards. You'll notice how one of America's best-loved stuffed animals, Ronald Reagan, have you noticed how lost he is when he doesn't have his cue card? But I'm thankful in a way that the technocrats up there that love us so much, the people in the suits that play God, have put so much time and effort into creating so many cartoon characters to keep me entertained and amused. I try to explain this to people, but they say, no, man, that's a fact. I read it in the paper, man. It's a fact. It's got to be true. And these kind of papers, like the National Enquirer and the Weekly World News, for years they've outsold these supposed truthful papers. Solid proof that people believe what they want to believe. We all do. I mean, you'll notice the Enquirer is now speaking not of actors and actresses' names, but the characters they play on television, though those characters are real. The New York Post always calls Reagan by his first name in their headlines. Ron thumps Democrats again. So if they're going to take all this time to give me all these great facts, I figured I should clip and save them for posterity and give them to you. So, how'd you like to be brainwashed with some truth and some facts? The way you make facts, you shake them up in this here Pan American Airlines barf bag, take some raw information, pour it out on the table, and what do you have? Truth! Presented to us by our fun-loving technocrats. So how about some truth, huh?
And what do you know? The first one on the pile says, nightly news programs today contain 25% fewer stories than they did just 6 years ago. Dateline Niles, Ohio. Fundamentalist minister Vernon Caton has denounced the Easter Bunny as a pagan god. And to prove his point, he has burned a giant effigy of a rabbit in the town square. Win a free night with me if you can get me a color picture of that incident for a record cover. Meanwhile, in Rome, a waiter named Antonio Ferranti has been arrested for including nude photos of himself in the menus he handed to restaurant patrons. Rolling Stone publisher Jan Wenner has put staff on notice that they may be tested for drugs. Oh, yes! True to form, former President Gerald Ford was recently spattered with eggs and snowballs by students at the University of Michigan. The students were actually aiming for Ed Meese. A part of the research undertaken by Ed Meese's Commission on Pornography, one of the commissioners wondered aloud, is it legal to have sex with a corpse if you're married to it? Guess what the ad campaign for Korean Airlines was right around the time that 747 got shot down over the Soviet Union? Korean Airlines. Our flights not only seem shorter, they are shorter! Half the scientists on Earth are known to be working on military projects. You wonder why they don't find a cure for it. Probably caused it, he says. Children between the ages of 10 and 15 can This summer, attend Money Management Camp for Kids. Activities for your 10-year-old include understanding the stock market, bonds and mutual funds, and personal financial planning. And you wonder why all them gray-suited zombies never seem to have much of a sense of humor. A gang of bandits have been whizzing around West Germany, robbing banks, wearing masks of President Reagan and Frankenstein. Authorities said the silly-looking rogues made off with 133 grand and 5 stick-ups before being caught 3 years later. A Soviet submarine fired an intercontinental ballistic missile aimed at the Kamchatka Peninsula in Siberia, right near where they shot that plane down, but they hit China instead. The SSN-8 missile veered 30 degrees south of the targeted landing area and into Manchuria. The missile's self-destruct command wasn't working any better than its guidance system. The Pentagon called the mishap just a glitch. The sort of thing that could happen to anyone. The Navy lost track of almost $320 million in aviation spare parts aboard its aircraft carriers last year. Where are they now? And finally, Ronald Reagan once confided to none other than Barbara Walters that the movie that most impressed him when he was growing up was Frankenstein! Put that in your pipe and smoke it tonight.